Officially, good afternoon to all of you. I hereby extend a hearty welcome to all participants logged to the online program about combating stress and promoting positive attitude, organized by Atomic Energy Center School No. 2, Mumbai. Dr. Rajni, Professor and Dean School of Ecology Work, Tata Institute of Social Science, was to come and speak to us today. Unfortunately, she could not make it due to some unforeseen engagements. We have with us Ms. Varnima Bhargava, a clinical psychologist and an assistant professor with Department of Human Ecology, Tata Institute of Social Science, Mumbai. She's a well-known expert in academic guidance and counseling. We also have with us Ms. Rupsa Karmakar, a MPhil scholar of Tata Institute of Social Science, Mumbai. My sincere thanks are due to Ms. Varnima Bhargava and Ms. Rupsa Karmakar for agreeing to guide this session today. Sri B. Venganna, our principal assistant to Mumbai, will join shortly as he is held up in an urgent meeting. I cordially invite our headmistress ma'am, Srimati Padmalata, to formally inaugurate the online program. Ma'am, please.
A warm good afternoon to one and all. On behalf of Sri B. Venkan, principal ACSO Mumbai, I take this opportunity to welcome you all. I take this opportunity especially to welcome our guest for the day, Ms. Swarnima Bhargava, Assistant Professor, School of Human Psychology, Tata Institute of Social Sciences. I am happy to welcome Ms. Rupsa Karmakar, who has also joined us, and she is a scholar. Welcome you both, ma'am. We are grateful to you for sparing your valuable time to guide us students of class 9, 10 on how to combat stress, promote positive attitude. Every day being poised to practice stress or to practice peace. To experience peace does not mean that your life is always blissful. It means that you are capable of tapping into a blissful state of mind amidst the normal chaos of a hectic life. These words seem true to each one of us, and students are no exception. We all know how stressed our students are these days. They are missing their friends, their play, their school, their teachers, and the classroom chatter. Sure, today's webinar will help all of us to combat stress and promote positive attitude. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am, and thank you so much, Dr. Pillai, for this really warm welcome. Both Rupsha and I are very excited to be here and to engage with all of you. And it was very, you know, it's good to see all of your faces on video. So without any further ado, I hand the session over to Rupsha to begin and take us through this. If at any point you have questions, please maybe make a note. And towards the end, we can do a question and answer round. So whatever questions you have, thoughts you'd like to share, anything that connected with you or that you have experienced yourself, we can keep some time towards the end to also have a more interactive conversation. Yeah, so with that, I hand it over to Rupsha.
Ma'am, one second, our session, yes, sir. We have got three links. Our session, first session finishes at 3:40. So I've sent the second link as well as third link to the group. So we'll just have a break for 2 or 3 minutes, then we'll join the second group, the second part, then the third link like that, ma'am. Thanks a lot, ma'am. Over to you, ma'am. Rupsha, ma'am.
Yeah. Hi, everyone. So I'm going to share something, just a second. Hello, everyone. So I hope it's visible to everyone. And you can give me a hands up, it's visible or not. Okay, I can see Dr. Pillai. So Parth, everyone is giving me hands up. So let's start. You know, I know this word stress is like a lot. I'm like someone giving me so much in a plate. So let's break down stress into a lot of small bits, so that you can actually deal with stress and just not, you know, get into the word of stress. Okay, so before we start, let's do something. Whatever is essential right now, like if you have a pen or paper, if you need a bottle of water, or if you need earphones or a quiet place to sit, if you can arrange that, it would be really good. Keep a bottle of water handy so that whenever you're thirsty, you can reach out to it. So now let's see what the word stress means. For me, stress is a great thing. You know, I have so much to do, so I'm already stressed right now. But what really makes you feel stress? Let's see that. And for you, you can write it down what stress means to you and any three things that reminds you of stress. For me, the three things would be my assignments and my submissions, my presentations. It goes on, okay? So you can write down three things which you really feel stressed right now, okay? Just write it down. Yeah?
So we'll give you all a minute. So you take a minute and you write down whatever would give you stress.
Okay, so let's see what stress really is. Okay, so you know what stress is? It's an automatic bodily response to any physical or mental demands placed on it. So when we are stressed, a neurochemical known as adrenaline is produced in our body, and then we either fight or flight from the situation, right? So you can ask me, is all stress bad? No, some stress is not bad. If you're not a bit stressed, you will not open your books before exam. Even I won't. So yeah, a bit of stress is okay. Or when you want to play a good game, a bit of stress is good for you. As you can see, in distress, you may feel sad, you may feel upset. But if it is a good stress, you can fulfill some needs. So let's see what stress does to the body. Sometimes what you feel is that you feel nervous. You feel so difficult to switch off. You feel that you are stressed in this way. Sometimes you can also just feel breathless. This can be short term, and in long term, your body and mind both can get affected, which includes, you know, you may feel a lot of headaches and you get stressed. Stress does to body. Let's see, are you stressed? You have to write down what are the things which stresses you the most right now. And how do you generally handle stress? You can write it down or you can put it in chat. Like how we generally handle stress. For me, I love cooking. So whenever I, you know, get free time, I just cook to handle my stress. On a scale of 1 to 10, how much stressed you are, you can write that down too. And I give you a minute or so for that. Yes? Okay, right now, I know many of you must be feeling a lot of things right now. You know, even I didn't get my convocation, so I can feel you. So the ideal situation would be like getting a farewell, you know, meeting your friends, playing out, going to school and meeting everyone out there and just saying hi to everyone. You know, even I miss that. And in real situation, what the real situation is because of Corona is that we're being home. We're not being able to do a lot of things and, you know, not meeting our near ones. You know, we can't play out. So let's find a medium ground. So in between the real and the ideal situation, we can find some solution to it. What we can do? We can virtually meet up like what we are doing right now. We can have our online classes and we can attend them. We can spend time with our family, who is the immediate one who is around us, and keep the connection with teachers, with friends, and also play a lot of indoor games. Whatever is possible, you know, you can go for it, right? So if we talk about what stress right now, like right now, what is really stressful is academics and, you know, COVID-related stress And the screen fatigue, I mean, like, look at us. We're just looking at a laptop, our mobile all the time. All the time. Who thought, like, initially when I used to look at my phone, my parents would be saying, what is this? Why do online? Now my parents know that I'm studying online. Okay, so, you know, good excuse I have. You know, then disturbed sleep cycle, eating, and the whole idea about exercising or socializing is also getting compromised. And loss and grief. So let's do something, guys. Let's think we are in a big bubble, right? And in that bubble, we have to think what is in your control. In that bubble, in your control, you have what you say, what you do, how you self-care of yourself, what you eat, how you set limits and boundaries, what you wear, and what you look online. Your words, your actions, and your thoughts. And after this big bubble comes a thing which is outside. In that outside, you have traffic, the coronavirus pandemic. Then you can also think about what other persons feel, the time, the weather, what other persons think. That is outside your control. So what is in your control is the bubble which is surrounding you, which includes your self-care, as I mentioned, your opinions, what you think is good for yourself, what you say, what you do, what you eat. So children, did you understand this? If you did, give me a hands up. Okay, I can see a lot of hands up. Yeah. So let's remember, this is the bubble, and your thoughts, your feelings, and what you do, what you eat, how many people you let in your life is your and your personal choice, and you keep them close to you. And whatever is outside the bubble is what other people think. That is not under the control. What is inside is under the control, right? Yes? Let's see some activities which we can manage during this stressful time. So what are the really, you know, what are the things we really need to manage? Firstly, the COVID related challenges. Then managing time and the daily routines, taking care of body. Then managing the big feelings. What are the big feelings? We are sometimes stressed, worried, sad, and anxious. But when these emotions are taking a majority of our time and we are thinking over it for a week or so or more, this becomes a big feelings. So how to take care of your big feelings and also how to meet the social needs. Let's see how we can manage the coronavirus related stuff. What you can do right now. Firstly, you can do virtual meetups. You can use a lot of technology that can make you and your friends close. That will not make, you know, sad. Like someone said in the beginning, you know, she saw her that friend after so many months. So what you can do is that you can virtually meet your friend through whatever social media. If you have FaceTime, if you have Zoom, if you have Skype or whatever, anything which is online platform, you can meet your friend, greet your friend and say hi to them. Taking out the me time. The me time is your time. That is your personal time. So every time we are with someone or the other, we are doing some work or we're trying to do something or the other. This me time, any time of the day, you take it out, particularly for yourself. There, you sit with yourself, you do whatever you feel like, maybe listening to a song, painting, you know, watching something, a good motivational video, anything that makes you feel happy, makes you feel that, you know, you are doing this, you're liking to do this. That is your me time. Okay, students. Keeping the routine similar. I mean, I can feel, you know, when, you know, school was got over, like suddenly one day, you know, school, college, university, everything closed out. Initially, even I was happy, you know, like, oh, this is a vacation, I'm off for a vacation, yay. Then, you know, my routine got in a toss, you know, it was at toss. Then I realized that keeping routine is so much important. And I can say that routine is just not like getting up on time, sleeping on time, but also, you know, what we do is something which has changed. So, you know, let's keep the routine as similar as possible, like that which have been before the pandemic. Like, you know, we know that we generally like to wear home clothes all the time, pajamas and all those things. But when we are, you know, meeting, going for online classes, let's have our work clothes on. Like, let's wear something which we would wear when we go out. So separate the work clothes and the home clothes. And eating, when we say eating, don't skip meals, you know, try to eat on time, try to sleep on time, not be awake too late at night, and taking proper rest. That would really help, you know, in the long term. You know, then what you can do is planning activities for pastime. I know it's like, you know, you want to go out and play in the grass, but you can't. I know, I understand that thing. So right now what you need to do is that planning fun indoor games. And, you know, interacting with friends who is near you and family members who is just near you. And I know that, you know, playing Ludo or the snake ladder or anything indoor is so interesting, right? You can try that, you know. Yeah. And going outside whenever possible. I know some bit of sunlight, a bit of fresh air is so important. So whenever your mother is going to get milk, if you can accompany her, or your father, if he's going to get some newspaper, so try to accompany him, but with protection. Everyone use your masks and your gloves if you are, and carry a sanitizer. So students, let's be little mindful, you know. Often what happens, we try to do 2 to 3 things at a time, okay? So when we are studying or when we are playing, let's keep it separate. When we are studying, we will only study. When we are playing, we will only play. Let's not do 2 things together. When we do 2 things together, it gets mixed up. So we will do study separately. We will play separately and we will interact with our family members or anyone separately. Let's not mix everyone. Okay. So let's do an exercise. I know we have been sitting for long. Okay. So just, you know, feel which part of your body feels most stressed. Okay. For me, it's my neck. It can be hand or your feet or your shoulders, anything. So what do you do? You stretch that part of the body. You can do with me if your neck is also aching like me. But also you can stretch your legs, you can stretch your shoulders and your hands if you want to. Let's stretch, okay? If you want to stretch, go ahead, come on. If you want to stretch, go ahead. Come on, students. Dr. Pillai, if you want to stretch, you can stretch. Like everyone can do it. Yes, go ahead, everyone. So let's do everything at once. Okay, let's remember that, you know. If we do everything together, it becomes a little, you know, messed up. So when we are studying, we only study. When we are doing something else, suppose we're just playing or we are want to talk to our friends, we do it separately. Okay.
Yeah, I think, sorry, Rupsha, just to add to what you were saying, I think, you know, mindfulness becomes very important because our brain is anyway running and processing so many different informations at the same time. And then sometimes we stress our brain out even more by trying to do 2 things at the same time. So for example, like if I'm attending this presentation right now, if I get a message on my phone or if I get an email, there's so much temptation to reply to those also or to talk to somebody. And I think it's very important that if, you know, if you're in a classroom, you focus in the classroom and you put your mind to what the teacher is saying at that time, because ultimately whatever is being taught or discussed is something that you need to understand and learn. And if you're reading it for the first time all alone, you know, by yourself later, either on the laptop or in your book, it's putting more pressure in your own brain. One pressure to pay attention to a little bit to what the teacher is saying, the other pressure to maybe reply to your friend or answer that email. And then I think later also pressure to make sense of this topic all by yourself without any help from what the teacher is saying. So the more we can make things easy for our brain by giving it one thing to do at a time, that can really improve our attention, our focus, how comfortable we feel, even using, you know, devices and using screens. So yeah. Just wanted to add that to what you said, Rupsha.
Yeah. Also, like, the whole idea about, you know, doing one thing at a time is really helpful, because, you know, I know that, you know, when everything is together, it becomes so messed up. So we just need to clear the clutter. No, just it's like keeping your jewelry in a box or keeping your notes separately. It's like we make files in our computer, right? It's the same way. Let's make different files for different things in our life, right? Okay, so if you guys understood this or anything you want to say, you just unmute and talk, or you just say, give a hands up. Yes. So I know exams are approaching. Everyone is stressed. Even I am stressed. My exams have approached. So let's plan our study and let's see how can we make it little, you know, little relaxing. Whenever we are planning our study, it's so difficult. It's like so much to do, so less time. So let's do it. So let's make a date chart first. What you need to do is, like, you need to write the date of the exam, how many days left, and according to that, you can divide the 24 hours to meet your study goals and other needs. So suppose your exam is on February 14th, okay? So what you do, you try to understand how many days are left, suppose, and, you know, let's, and also dividing the time you want to study that, you know, subject, and, you know, see how it goes. So I just kept a, you know, thing where you can plan your study according to your needs. So you can put the exam date and then the topics that needs to be covered, the difficulty level of the topics and the total points when you are done. And you, whatever you need, you can write it down or you can just keep it handy around you. So whenever you are planning your study, you can put anything in that. You can put a lot of colors, you can put means, anything that makes you feel happy and, you know, in that space. So you can do it like this. You can use a highlighter, use color pencils, sketch pencils, anything that makes you realize that, okay, this much is left, I have to do this much, or this much is done, I need to do this much. So you can do like this, okay? Okay, so when we are saying, let's concentrate, any place in the house where you are comfortable, you feel calm and soothing, you can study there and you can invest your time there. You can postpone, like, watching television, playing games, you know, adhering to phone calls at that point of time. And if you try to minimize that room and minimize noise in that room and be comfortable, that will also be really good. Because some place, you know, you feel very close to, you feel very happy when you're studying, that will really enlighten your mood. You can go ahead and sit in that place and, you know, talk there, you know, feel good about that place there. Yeah. Let's prepare a sandwich, guys. I know that, you know, sandwich is like something which we all like eating. It's like tasty, it's easy. So what happens in sandwich? We use bread, then we use salad or cheese. Then again, we take a piece of bread. Okay. So if we do our studies that way, how will that sound? Yes, good or bad? Good, bad? Okay. No. What will it sound like? How will it feel like if we make a sandwich? Huh? Okay. Someone did give me this. Okay. So let's make a sandwich. So first you do the easy subject. Okay. Suppose you like history. It's easy for you. Okay. It's an example. Okay. You do it. You take history. You do it. You keep it ready. Okay. Then you take a difficult subject, which you find very difficult to do. Okay. You take that difficult subject and what you do? You take help from your friends, your family, anyone. It can be a teacher. It can be anyone who is near to you. Don't be shy or ashamed. Just go and say that, can you help me in this chapter? I'm not understanding. And, you know, take help from them. Take help from your teachers and try to do that subject. After you're done with the subject, what you do? You treat yourself. You say that, yes, good job. I did it. So what you do? You treat yourself. And then you can go back to easy subject. So you see the pattern, students. First, it's easy. Then it's hard, like the difficulty of cutting salads and putting the cheese thing. And then you go back to the easy thing, like bread. Okay? You can do that. Yeah? Okay. Okay, students. So, you know, because there's a lot of things to study and a lot of things to remember, what we do, we study, we take rest, we do our work, then we study. So what we do take small breaks in between and we try to sleep for 8 hours or whenever we feel drowsy, we can take a nap and, you know, try to not overwork during exam days. Try to prepare beforehand. Don't be awake before exam. Is my PPT visible? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Even I am technologically handicapped. Okay. So I also get worried. Oh my God, screen is not there. What will I do? Now I am done. So yes, thank God Swarnima ma'am is there. Dr. Pillai is there. All of you are there to support me. Same way, you know, even I got stressed right now. You can see. Yes. So where were we? Taking rest. Okay. So when we are talking about taking rest, what we can do is that, like, you know, having a good sleep, you know, try to sleep for 8 hours and, you know, taking a nap whenever you're drowsy, you know, and don't overwork during the time of exam, because if you're tired during the exam time, you can't write anything. So it's better to sleep and, you know, relax and prepare ahead than exam ke pehle, you know, doing everything together. So it becomes a little difficult at that point of time. Yeah. Okay. So let's do some exercise to beat the stress. Okay. Let's beat it up. So what we can do right now, if someone, and many of you are wearing spectacles, you can open your spectacles and keep aside. Okay. And listen to me. Okay. Even I'm doing that. So you can do that too. You can open your spectacles, keep aside. Okay. So what you do, take your palm. Okay. Rub it nicely. Yeah. Till it's warm and put it in your eyes, on top of your eyes, not in your eyes, on top of your eyes. Yeah. Take deep breath. And slowly, you can keep your hands down. And you can slowly open your eyes. Take some time, students. It's okay. A minute or so. Just deep breathe. If you feel good, then we can continue. Okay? Slowly. You can open your eyes. You can wear your spectacles. You can orient to the place you're sitting. Yeah? Okay. So, whenever we are stressed, you know, there are several things that has been going on in body. So, we need to calm that thing down, right? So, firstly, what you can do is that you can deep breathe. Okay? So you can take your, you know, breath from the stomach and take a deep breath like this. And slowly, you know, leave that breath. Okay. Slowly and slowly you do it. You can do a lot of stretching. You can listen to good music, whichever, whatever makes you feel happy. You know, the good music. You can make vision boards, which includes formulas, charts, graphics, like whatever is there, you know, the charts, graphics, you can put it in the wall. You can put it in the, you know, Almira, and, you know, just look at it whenever you are, you know, preparing for something, exam, anything, you know, you can do a calm place exercise. So in that, you sit down, you close your eyes and imagine a place that makes you feel very calm and very safe. It can be maybe a place which you have visited before, maybe a hill station or the seaside, you know, which you have gone, or anything that makes you feel happy. When you do the calm place exercise, you will feel a lot better, and, you know, a lot calm, you know, compared to that. Also, you can just sit in a comfortable position and listen to whatever is going around, right? Okay. So yes, this is something which is very, you know, relevant, because even I don't do it. So the thing is that I'm trying to, you know, focus on more greens right now. So whenever you look at your plate, try to focus more on green, red, everything that gives color to the food. Okay. Try to take a lot of healthy food and healthy homemade food and avoid junk, very deep fried stuffs. Try to drink a lot of water and juices and be hydrated. You know, you can also unwind by talking to someone you trust, watching something very funny, which is, you know, which you can relate and, you know, you can laugh. I love watching Shin Chan, you know. So you can just see what you like watching and, you know, and talk to someone, you know. So during this whole pandemic, the only thing, the thing which really affected is the social relationships, you know, and how, and the whole idea about social relationships getting cut up from us is so difficult, right? Like suddenly in the month of March, you said that, you know, everything will be closed down. You can't go to school. Until now, it's like, you know, we all are struggling to, you know, meet that, you know, whole needs meet. So let's, you know, whenever we talk about how to maintain social relationships right now, what you can do, you can study with your classmates, you know, study with your friends virtually, participate in a lot of group discussions online, you know, create a club for yourself, which can be a book club. It can be a club where you can review things. You can talk about what is happening in class, you know, whatever is you're reading in class. Suppose you're not understanding something, you can discuss it in the group. So make something which is book club or something of that sort, which you can feel comfortable. So you can hang out virtually. What you can do, you can text your friend whenever you get time. You can give a phone call to your friend. You know, you can schedule a regular online call with a group of your friend. You can play online game with your friend. You can play, you can, you know, create a playlist together and listen to favorite songs together, because nowadays a lot of music app is giving that option, you know, you can hear this songs together, you know, this you can do. And you can plan an online event, you know, where you can do separate things like singing, dancing, reciting, acting, everything, whatever, you know, you feel happy, you can do it together. So, you know, suppose you didn't get the farewell, okay, and you want the farewell so badly, so you can organize an online event. You know, you can wear the good pink sari you want to, or the pink or the blue salwar kameez or the bow tie you want to. Go ahead, wear that, you know, and have that online session with your friends, you know, sing, dance, you know, make fun, and, you know, do whatever you want online right now. So let's do another exercise, okay? So what you need to do is hug yourself. You know, I also, you know, everyone wants to meet your friends and, you know, hug your friends and say that, you know, how much you love them. So that same love, let's shower to ourselves, okay? Let's hug ourselves. Come on, come on, let's hug. Come on, everyone who is online, let's hug ourselves. Come on, let's tightly hug ourselves and say that we can do it. We can overcome the stress. Come on, let's hug ourselves. Yeah? Hug yourselves tight. Come on. Even I am hugging. So yeah, everyone hug yourself. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. And let's process that emotions that are, you know, there when we are hugging ourselves, okay? Yeah. So another thing what we can do is that we can be mindful of our feelings. So often what happens because of a lot of, you know, tension going around or, you know, just being at home or just, you know, studying for a long time, what happens? We get, you know, a little tired or a little worried about something. So what are the five things we can do in a tip of our fingers? Let's do it. First thing is that you can see the five things which are around. For me, it can be my red pen. It can be the water bottle that's around. It can be a picture that's hanging there. Or it can be the copy which is beside me. So I have a lot of, I can see five, six things around me. Similarly, if you all can see the five, six things around you, can you see it? Yes? Can you see five things around you? Move your eyes, look around. See if you can have five things. Yeah? Yes? Mm-hmm. Yeah? Then, the four things that you can hear. Close your eyes for 1 minute and listen to the things you can hear. Hear the things. It can be the crows. It can be a car whizzing past. It can be your mother cooking. The pressure cooker whistling by. So just four things. Close your eyes and think about and feel about that here and hear the four things that's like right now which you can hear. You can do that. Yeah. Yeah. Now the three things you can smell. Let's smell the three things. It can be a good agarbatti in your house, you know, a good perfume. It can be flowers your mother gave or you gave. It can be the smell of paint, whatever you feel good, the three good smell. Take a deep breath and just smell it, you know, whatever is good. Feel some oxygen in your lungs and smell things. Okay, and the two things you can taste. Okay, I know you can't eat right now, like, but the two favorite thing, like some, suppose mango bite or any fruit which you like or anything, the two taste which is close to you, you can eat. And one thing that you can touch. For me, it is like this. I can touch my kurti. It's like, it's soft. I can touch that. So that's the same thing. You touch something, you feel your skin, you touch it. You do like this with your palms. You touch it. You touch the water bottle, which is near. So yeah, touch it. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, students. If you're okay in proceeding, just give me a. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So often what happens, you know, like whenever we are stressed or even if you're not stressed, we're just feeling so sad or worried or very, you know, negative. What we can do is that create a flower of positivity. So when we are talking about positivity, it's about the positive self-talk to ourselves. What we can tell ourselves when we are stressed, we are worried, we are anxious, we are, you know, we're just thinking about many things right now. So yeah, you can say you can and you will in yourself, like I can, I will, everything is possible if I try. I trust and believe myself. I love and accept myself. So you see, there is a flower. You can also make a flower for yourself, you know, that you can control your happiness. You know, today you can do it. Today you are feeling good. You can write that for yourself. Okay. So hi everyone. So this is also for parents. And Dr. Pillai, I don't know if parents are around, but this is like the section I have kept for parents and teachers like right now. So if they are here, parents, you can give me a this thing or you can say hi to me if parents are here.
Teachers are also there, ma'am.
Yeah, if teachers are there, if parents are there. And students, you can tell your parents to sit beside you. It's fine. Come on. Tell your parents also to join them. Like, join you guys. Like, okay. Whoever has mother, father, anyone. your grandparents, whoever you feel close is near you, you can sit beside them right now. Yeah. If parents are there, yeah, I can continue. Yeah. Yeah. So, yes. So should I see Dr. Pillai? Swanima ma'am, should I see? Or should I wait for some parents to join in?
Parents are already there, ma'am. The students,
you can start it.
Please give their thumbs up.
If parents
and
are
those
there,
those of you whose parents
up.
Are maybe not here. Those of you whose parents are maybe not here, you could maybe, you know, make some notes and jot it down and share it with them as well. Because like, you know, the things that Ruksha was saying earlier, that this pandemic is unfolding for all of us and all our lives have been changed by it. That includes your parents. I'm sure you must be seeing some of your parents working from home. Some of you may be seeing your parents running around doing a lot of extra work, especially last year when, you know, people weren't allowed to come in. So parents were doing everything. Similarly, your teachers are also coping with the pandemic and they're also spending, I think, more time with their laptops than probably they've ever spent. They've also had to, you know, adapt to learning these new technologies, figuring out things like this, you know, the Cisco WebEx. So it's been a, you know, challenging time for everybody. And sharing some of these tips maybe with a class teacher, sharing these tips with your parents definitely is something that can, you know, help them also cope with their stress level. Yeah, so over to you, Rupsha.
Yeah. So hi, if parents are there, hi to all of you. Hi, how I hope you all are, you know, like battling the whole, you know, this whole pandemic, you know, running, doing office work. Many of you may be frontline workers and it must be difficult for every one of you. So there are some things which I can say, like from a novice perspective, but also like whatever, if you want to feel, you know, you want to talk, you can just, you know, say or give me a thumbs up or anything. So, you know, the most important thing is that staying connected to the school. I mean, children are there, children are going to school. But you as a parent, I mean, it's very important. The small chit chats you may have with someone's mother is stopped now, but you know, you can regain that, you know, you can just see if there are avenues to that. So, you know, so connect with teachers and know what your child is studying and what online resources are available. You know, sometimes you can check in Google or whatever is handy to you, you can check that way. Stay in touch, you know, find out how the school is communicating with you, your family, and, you know, if your child is old, you know, just check on them if they're having any message for you and anything, any parent teachers meeting that is available online or any remedial class or anything that is being conveyed to you. Yeah. So you can reach out to your child's teacher and other relevant, you know, school staffs who you can, you know, talk about concerns and anything, you know, if your child is, you know, sometimes, you know, they're getting worried about some assignments or activities, you can talk to them. You know, you can also share that difficulty or they can, you know, talk to you regarding what they feel. So yeah, it's a vice versa process. So yeah. Yeah. So there are some self-care tips for parents. So, you know, you can actually take short breaks whenever possible. I know, like from morning till evening, like working, cooking, you know, cleaning. If you're doing it all by yourself, it must be a little difficult job. So, you know, take a break for yourself. Do something with your children, which includes maybe, you know, potting a plant and watering it together, you know, trying to, you know, learn cooking together, something new dish, or, you know, painting together, dancing together, anything which you can do together with your child, playing together in home, you know, nurture something together. I already covered it, but it's like nurturing something which includes, you know, it can be a simple thing like hobby. If you and your daughter or son share the whole idea of, you know, playing basketball is something which you want to do, just go for it. Like nurture that thing together in your house or in whatever small space available. You know, talk about your feelings with your partner whoever is like available right now, if you know, often the whole idea is very overwhelming, but the situation is very overwhelming. So you can talk to your partner about it. You know, exercise with your family, stretch with your family. And you yourself do something which you want to do, you really wanted to do, like some hobby or some course or any class you wanted to do, and reach you yourself also reach out to any support system that's available, you know, to you. Yeah, so this section is for teachers. And as ma'am said that, you know, like already spending time in laptop and now full day we are in laptop, in front of laptop and doing things. So as teachers, what you can do, you know, stay connected to your parents, the children and each other, you know, your colleagues, you know, and virtually talk, meet, discuss with your colleagues regarding work and planning of work. Like whenever you're trying to plan something, you know, it's always a good idea, you know, have a quick meeting, you know, just talk to everyone, you know, say hi. And, you know, this is what I'm feeling. This is the challenges I'm feeling and I want to overcome that. So your colleagues can also be a good source of understanding at this point of time. Practice self-care activities, you know, whatever, if it is a bubble bath, if it is, you know, having a warm cup of tea, you know, just having sunlight, you know, that if that is also possible, go for that, taking fresh air if that is possible. Set and maintain boundaries. You know, sometimes everything is overlapping with each other. So it's very important that you set boundaries for everything, you know, this is the schoolwork and this is my housework and, you know, understanding that this is a boundary to it, you know, taking breaks often and starting the day on a positive note, anything which makes you feel positive in the morning, go for that. Yeah, so I have made a stressful day to-do list like you all can see, like taking a time out, going out, slowing down, calling up a friend. Consider how lucky you are today and, you know, compliment yourself that, you know, you are like, suppose your hair today is good. Just compliment yourself, you know, often as teachers, we often like getting worried about a lot of things. So yes, compliment that how you can eat a cup of a good warm tea and feel happy eating something, a slice of banana or kiwi and making and feeling happy about it. You can go for it. Okay. So choose technology that supports you, you know, teacher. I mean, it's so difficult. So many things are online. There is like 10, 15 of these apps where you can have online meeting, but try to find something which is handy, which is easy, which you all can operate. Okay. So the whole idea of reattach, detach, and repeat. So the thing is that whenever we are reattaching, the whole idea about reattaching is that we are reattaching to the laptop again, or we are detaching from the laptop and we're repeating it. So when we're reattaching something, we just do it with care so that, you know, we're not stressed ourselves, which will reflect later. So yes, trim your list. Okay, whatever, suppose you have 10, 20 things to do today, the most important things, make it a top priority in the highlighter and then do that. Okay. And don't try to overburden yourself during this time, you know, pass your umbrella. Suppose something you can't do, if there is any trustworthy colleague, friend, any teacher who you trust, you just pass that work. You can ask for help, you know, and, you know, you just want to talk about something regarding that, ask some advice. You can go ahead with that. Allow yourself to stop. Sometimes just, you know, stop, breathe and rephrase all the emotions that has been there and just continue with your work. Yeah. So this is something which you can do. Like you can connect on Monday, be active on a Tuesday, take notice on a Wednesday and keep learning on a Thursday and give on a Friday. You can adjust this, you know, schedule according to you. But, you know, the way you connect, you are active or you're taking notice about things and, you know, learning, everyone is learning. So this is something you can, you know, see and look forward to. Yeah. Yeah. So, yeah, according to Terry Gilmetz, give your stress wings and let it fly away. So, yeah, thank you, guys. Thank you, everyone. So, yeah. Now we are open for comments, whatever reflection, questions, whatever you want to say.
Children, you have got any doubts? Now we are free to ask teachers. Children, you unmute yourself and you can
parents,
ask.
Parents, anyone. Yeah.
Yeah, so you can put questions down on chat. You can put questions. I mean, you can unmute yourselves, whatever you're comfortable with.
Then you can put the question from chat.
So if any teachers want to talk, I'm like, we are open for it. Like, then we can ask, you know, the students again, like anyone who wants to talk, if anyone wants to share their thoughts.
Ma'am, there's a question from a child. We are stressed often nowadays. Instead of avoiding stress, can one channel it?
So I would pay attention to what Rupsha had said in the beginning. So if we look at stress like a U, you know, like a inverted U. So a little bit of stress is good and a little bit of stress helps us to be energized. Yeah. So if I didn't care about my exam at all, I would have no incentive to start studying. So a little bit of anxiety, a little bit of stress helps you to be better prepared. Now, you have to judge for yourself that is the amount of stress I'm feeling, is it helping me to prepare? Is it helping me to study? Or am I getting so stressed out that I feel ke I'll do it later, kal karenge, baad mein karenge. So is it making me procrastinate? Is it making me delay my work? Is it making me so anxious and stressed that I'm forgetting what I have learned? So you need to ask yourself the question, when I feel this stress, what is the effect it has on me? What do I do next after getting stressed to this level? So if you find ke on a scale of 1 to 10, it's at a, you know, 5 and below, it's medium stress, then that might be something that you can channel into studying. When you get stressed, when you think of studying, so then you can maybe make a plan. Those ideas that Rupsha shared with us about how to make a schedule, you can do that thinking at that point. However, if you say that, oh no, right now my level is at an 8 or a 9. So at that time, instead of studying, I would suggest that you maybe tell a friend about it. Tell your parents about it. That, you know, abhi mujhe achha nahi lag raha hai. Abhi mujhe ghabrahat ho rahi hai, tension ho rahi hai. And at that time, you do those activities and exercises that Rupsha spoke about, whether it's, you know, grounding, looking at 5 things, smelling things, whether it's saying something like, okay, right now I'm too anxious, I'm going to try to maybe calm myself, I'm going to take a nap, or I'm going to watch my favorite show. Something that helps you to bring that level down closer to 5, you know, upar se wo niche kaise aa sakta hai. So I hope that answers your question. If there are any other questions, feel free to ask us.
And this is again a question from a child. In what ways can we keep the negative thoughts away?
Rupsha, would you want to talk about this?
Yes. One of my slides actually consisted of positive self-talk. I told you guys about the flower, na? I hope everyone has seen that flower. Okay. So whenever you're having certain negative thoughts, what you can do is that combat it with the positive thoughts. Okay. Like, yes, I can do it. Yes, I am able to love myself. Yes, I will be able to complete this chapter. And if you feel like too much of negative thought is overpowering you, what you can do, you can take a deep breath and, you know, release it and close your eyes and count from 1 to 5 backward. And then say that, yes, you can do it. You know, this is something like, you know, you can just think that what are the things which are working and what are the things which you have in your control, which you can do it. Like I talked about the big bubble, right? You are in that bubble and whatever you think, you feel, you eat is under your control. Those are the things which you can do it. And what is outside that bubble is what other people are thinking, what other people are feeling. You know, I fought with someone, that is, you know, that's outside. What inside is under your control, right? I hope this
I think one other thing that happens when negative thoughts come, usually, you know, we zoom into the future. Negative thought is about kal kya hoga. अगर अभी पढ़ाई नहीं की कल मैं एग्जाम में फेल हो जाऊंगी, अभी होमवर्क नहीं किया कल टीचर डांटेंगे, अभी कमरा साफ नहीं किया मम्मी डांटेंगी. सो अ लॉट ऑफ नेगेटिव थॉट इज रिलेटेड विद द फ्यूचर कि आगे क्या होने वाला है. सो पर्सनली व्हाट आई फाइंड हेल्पफुल इज टू से के ओके, अगर कल मुझे ये नहीं चाहिए तो अभी मैं क्या कर सकती हूँ, यू नो. एंड गोइंग बैक टू व्हाट रूपशा इज सेइंग कि क्या मैं अभी इसके बारे में कुछ कर सकती हूँ, राइट, कि जितना मैं कर सकती हूँ मैं उतना करूंगी, उससे ज्यादा अगर मैं नहीं कर सकती हूँ फिर तो वो मेरे कंट्रोल के बाहर है. right? So just ask yourselves, can I do something to change that, you know, horrible future right now? And if I can, then let me spend my present moment trying to do that, trying to change that future. Any other questions?
Ma'am, actually, it's observed that during this time of pandemic, students are more addicted to video games and other methods. So that addiction part, there should be a limit. Ma'am, please say some points regarding that.
To what your everyday life looks like, maybe so much things are not happening. You know, maybe you are bored sitting in the same room, in the same house, not doing things. So why you want to play video games makes a lot of sense. But again, I think what Dr. Pillai is also trying to say is, if I'm spending so much time here, what else am I neglecting? Right? So within that 24 hours, I can play video games for 4 hours, 8 hours, 10 hours, and it's a lot of fun. But do I have to pay the price for that later? Because later when I see mera homework nahi hua hai, maine kisi se baat nahi ki hai, maine koi exercise nahi kiya hai, shayad maine khana bhi nahi khaya. You know, so all those other needs then pile up, and that stress can affect your mind and your body. So aisa nahi hai ki video game mat khelo, but I think it's more about aap video game kab khel rahe ho. Am I playing a video game at a time jab mujhe homework karna hai? Am I playing a video game jab class chal rahi hai? Am I playing a video game raat ke 12 baje jab sone ka time hai? So I think these are things that you need to start to regulate a little bit for yourself. And I think it's also good practice to kind of say no to something, because video game may be, agar aap usi level pe atke hue ho and you're playing it again and again and again, sooner or later you're going to get bored with that video game, you're going to get bored with that level. So let it stay fresh, let it stay exciting, let the video game stay a break. You know, like Rupsha was talking about a sandwich. Let the video game be one part of the sandwich, but not like the main chunk in the middle. So any other questions, anything, Dr. Pillai, from your experience of, you know, interacting with the students, have there been things that they have said to you, things you've heard, you know, any problems you've seen, any concerns you've seen?
Ma'am, from different feedback I've got, we noticed that the children now are little, they're showing their angerness in a full thread, that too, to their parents, and reflected everywhere. So that angerness, how to control that?
Yeah, so what Rupsha was talking about, small feelings and big feelings. You know, everybody gets angry. Everybody feels irritated, happy, sad, upset, anxious, worried. These are normal feelings, right? So in your everyday life, you will feel this. But it becomes problematic when you have any of them becoming very big. So I find myself feeling angry every day, or I find myself feeling so angry that I'll, you know, pick up my laptop, pick up my phone and throw it. I'll maybe push somebody, say something that I deeply regret later. So I think that's when anger becomes a very big feeling. And I think always, you know, there is something underlying anger, particularly. Am I angry because I'm anxious? Am I angry because I'm bored? Am I angry because, like Dr. Pillai said, that I have so much energy, I don't know what to do with it? Am I angry ke, you know, mujhe achha nahi lag raha hai, ye itne haftoon se aisa hi chal raha hai, ki kab khatam hoga? So I think it's also about asking yourself, ki mujhe kyun itna gussa aa raha hai? Aur mujhe lagta hai ki when you're asking your parents or you're getting angry with them, maybe you're also hoping ke wo ye gusse ko sambhal lenge. They'll be able to make it better for you. They'll be able to take care of you. So I think maybe it's also about saying, can you tell your parent, hey, I'm not feeling okay, and can you help me with this? Instead of getting angry with them. You know, jaise agar aap kabhi travel kar rahe hote ho na, ek gaadi mein aap baithe ho ya train mein baithe ho, aur aapko impatience ho raha hota hai ki kab pahunchenge. और आप मम्मी या पापा को पूछते हो कि अब पहुंचेंगे और कितना टाइम और कितना टाइम. सो आई थिंक हम ये भूल जाते हैं कि मम्मी पापा भी तो हमारे साथ उसी ट्रेन में बैठे हैं. जब वो पहुंचेंगे तब हम पहुंचेंगे, जब हम पहुंचेंगे तब वो पहुंचेंगे. सो यू नो वी आर ऑल इन दिस टुगेदर. राइट नाउ हमारे पेरेंट्स, हमारे टीचर्स, ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स, फ्रेंड्स, सिबलिंग्स, हम सब उसी ट्रेन में बैठे हुए हैं और हम उसी स्पीड में आगे बढ़ रहे हैं. So I think that's also something, you know, important to keep in mind. Ki jo aapke saath ho raha hai, wo sabke saath ho raha hai. Rupsha, would you like to add anything?
Yeah, I can, like Dr. Pillai and students, I can relate to all of you, because even like as a student, as someone who is learning and, you know, understanding, I'm also getting angry. So if you ask me that, you know, how to manage this anger. So whenever I get angry, what I do is that, as ma'am said, it's like, if I feel that my mother is okay, I can talk about it. I can say that, my mom, that, you know, let's talk about it. Or any friend, anyone you trust, you can unwind to them. You can talk to them. You talk to them. If you have like a lot of energy in you, just, you know, do something, like do stretching, you know, sit somewhere and do a lot of, you know, meditation, stretching, write your feelings down, you know, keep a diary to yourself, write what you're feeling, you know, why did you feel bad today? And why? Like, some things like, I'm angry today. So write it down. Identify your emotions, you know, like, okay, I'm angry. Like, as ma'am said, you know, why am I angry? Because maybe I'm in pain. Maybe because I'm overthinking about something. So write it down. And if you can talk to anyone, any teacher, friend, relative, your sister, brother, anyone, go ahead, reach. Don't be ashamed. You know, like, I just felt that from 2020 to 2021, it was a, you know, so slow. It's like this year is not going. But, you know, as you can see, this year has gone. We're in the middle of January. Things are getting better. And let's be happy. You know, you can see from Pune, the whole idea about vaccine is getting everywhere. Everyone will get their vaccines. By a year or so, maybe 6 months, everything is going to be fine. You're going to be back to what you are. So, yeah. Just treat it like a vacation period. It happened, and we are all in that thing. We are all in the thing together, right?
Questions are over.
Okay.
Yeah. So, children, if still there's a doubt or any queries, you can please post it to me, and I'll forward it to ma'am. So later also you can do that. So officially, thank you, Miss Varnima Bhargava ma'am, and Miss Rupsha Karmakar ma'am. Once again, for the inspiring and motivating speech, I hope all student participants will benefit handsomely from this session. Ms. Varnima Bhargava and Ms. Rupsha Karmakar session will prepare you to approach online learning and examinations in a gainful and stress-free manner. Let me take this opportunity to express my heartfelt gratitude to Sri Ashok Vangre, Chairman, Local Management Committee, Atomic Energy Center School, Junior College, Mumbai. Our principal, Sri B. Vengana, still held up in the meeting. Our Padmalata ma'am, headmistress, school 2, all teachers and non-teaching staff of ACS 2 Mumbai had extended every possible help to conduct this program and make it a success. I also thank my colleague, Srimati Rajeshwari, for her support and encouragement. Let me also mention sincere gratitude to the parents of the students who have participated in this session. Last but not least, let me wish all student participants of this program all the very best in their academic endeavors. Thanks a lot. Thank you, ma'am, Rupsha ma'am. Thank you, Sonia ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, everybody.
Thank you. Thank
and
you.
All the best, students.
Thank you, and all the best to students. To take care, everyone. Dr. Pillai, take care, and everyone who is there. Be happy, take care, have a good life, you know.